Just do it.
Hello, my beautiful persons. Welcome to a Nintendo Direct reaction with all four of these beautiful people.
I'm Will.
I'm Alec.
I'm Book or Elijah.
And I'm Sam. And Ali, may I correct you that you said four beautiful people? Are you sure that all four of us are beautiful?
So it's about 45 minutes long. That's a bit shorter than I expected, but shall we?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, shoot! Mature content!
It's not Nintendo.
Mature?
Are you sure this isn't for Sony?
That's actually a really separate thing.
Please welcome Nintendo President and COO, Reggie.
It's this is really
It's like,
it's Robot Chicken.
If you say so.
Welcome to E3 Nintendo fans. You guys thought we wouldn't have a press conference. Not my problem. We have Nintendo's biggest stars backstage, ready to make some big announcements.
I bet you
Oh, great! Another Mario game!
Don't love your tone, but actually no new Mario game today.
Oh,
what?
Nice!
How am I getting bumped?
Oh,
wait,
what the hell?
My cards around.
Fox, Fox.
Hey, hey, looks like I'm the new face of Nintendo. Hey, they promised me you would be here! Come on, Reggie,
this
give
is
us
failing.
Another
really
three!
Funny.
How about this instead?
Well, there you go.
Amazing.
Hey, wait a minute.
I love
the Nintendo
this.
Heroes are backstage. Who's
are
watching the bad guys?
Not my problem.
It's me, Wario!
I guess this
oh.
is my problem.
Did
While
Mario
I go Reggie
the
on these fools, here's what's new.
Pop culture reference.
I'm loving this already.
Wow.
This is the
this is really scary.
Yeah.
This whole thing has been terrifying.
No, this is amazing. It's like fucking
slow. Oh my god!
This is why they had
the power of
soul
going.
Are they gonna fight?
Oh,
are they gonna fight?
Yeah,
no. Is this Nintendo Combat?
Ah.
This is the best thing ever.
I know.
Oh my god. Action.
Richie's gonna win. Come on, Richie.
I don't know, I'm not sure if his body was ready at the start.
Is he, I guess, what is happening?
What? I would tell him
why? Oh my god, he's in the direct fit.
If Reggie doesn't do it, my body is ready. So.
I know.
This is better than Dragon Ball Z.
This is amazing.
So when did they go Super Saiyan?
The funny thing is that Obama is so stressed
oh
that he couldn't come to the maximum event, so this is in Japan.
Yes!
Smash Bros. What is it? Okay, we actually talked
about it.
Sorry, guys. We are
we
got spoiled, but
we went to go watch it.
Yay! So happy there.
I didn't really watch it, but I did.
I'm sure. I totally did.
I did.
It doesn't mean they're Reggie.
Oh, okay. So
plus, I really like that they have actual weapons instead of like
Reggie gets to be in Smash Bros.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Wait, so do you just get to play as Sakurai and Reggie, or do you get to play as all of you?
I think you're going
to
get the
whole line. Oh, and it's a
cool as a is it? Oh, whatever.
Oh, they got rid of tripping and they're adding bait.
Oh, that was annoying.
Of course.
It's that's a shield breaker.
Reggie wins.
Oh, wait a second.
Lame.
What?
Lame.
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 Wait,
Skylanders, but fighting game with Mario.
Yeah.
Wait,
no,
what?
It's
what
just,
happened?
No, guess what?
What
yeah.
Happened?
You
what
don't
just happened?
Get to
how
unlock the
that?
Characters. You have to buy them.
No, but that's not what they're doing. It's something.
That doesn't. Why would they not do that when they just had a Skylanders thing? What?
What?
No.
I know.
No.
Hello. I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited. Here at the Nintendo Digital event, I'd like to lead off by talking about Super Smash Bros. Right now, you're seeing two familiar bigwigs facing off in a friendly battle. But this isn't a simple pre-rendered animation. What you are seeing will be possible in the new Smash Bros. Games. Now, by using a Mii fighter, anyone can join the battle.
Who do they have doing his voice?
I know.
I thought about having Mii characters appear in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, but in the end decided against it. Somehow at the time, it didn't seem right to have Miis punching and kicking. For this game, though, we're not simply throwing the Miis into the fray. We've done some serious work getting them ready for a fight.
Awesome!
Have a look. They're almost not even Miis anymore.
Oh!
I think they're like,
hey, let's destroy one of their characters. I'm actually really happy.
Yeah,
we can all
yeah.
fight each other.
It's like a Samus Mii. What the hell? It's like a Samus Mii.
Oh my god.
Elijah, you're gonna have to actually make the experiment.
No. Yes.
I think you can tell that the Miis are going to be just as competitive as the other characters. Mii fighters will come in three varieties. Brawlers fight empty-handed and prefer to be up close and personal. Mii brawlers are both fast and powerful. Sword fighters are weapon masters. They stay cool and calm as they chase down opponents. Gunners are armed with mysterious arm cannons. They have lots of different projectiles that can be fired from long range.
They're major pussy trolls.
Brawlers, sword fighters, and gunners. Each type is treated as a separate fighter.
Yeah, I'm playing as the gunner.
And each type can choose four special moves from 12 options. This means that the Mii fighters will have a total of 36 special moves from which to choose. It would take 9 regular fighters to equal that number of moves. But I didn't decide to include Miis in the lineup just so you or your friends could join the battle. See, every day, I receive requests for new characters to be added to the game, and now you can use Miis to recreate any character you like and fight as them. Anyone can join the battle. You can fight. Anyone can fight. This is your chance to defeat Nintendo's greats.
Tomodachi's mad. Actually, that's pretty cool.
Not gonna lie, I'm kind
of excited. We're fast approaching the sales date of the 3DS version.
Just wait.
Yeah, let's hear.
The game is almost complete, but of course there are an astronomical number of variables in a game like this. We have to be sure to put enough people on the debug team and test it correctly. Thank you for your patience. We've put all our focus into getting the fighters, items, assist trophies, stages, and enemy characters ready and in the game. And there are many different modes besides the main Smash battles. I won't go over them in detail now, but let me show you a bit of what's in store for you.
That's it.
There are many more game elements that we haven't introduced yet, but I don't think we can talk about them all before we release. However, this will be our first Smash Brothers game on handheld, so I hope you're all looking forward to Super Smash Brothers for Nintendo 3DS.
We sold out.
Yes!
Oh! Fuck, that's a long time.
No, I was like, yeah.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Nintendo's digital event at E3. This year we wanted to do something different to celebrate what it means to be a Nintendo fan. Today you'll meet many of the talented Nintendo teams working hard to deliver great games and hear some of our big E3 news, with more to be shared throughout the show. While I've changed out of my Fireflower suit for now, Mario is still close to my heart. You may recognize this as what Mr. Iwata used earlier to defeat my Mii fighter in Super Smash Bros. Now, I'll say there's no way he beats me without resorting to a little magic. And in fact, I'm right. That's exactly what he did. Because this is no ordinary toy. This is one of the first in a new line of products Nintendo has in development called Amiibo.
So,
and only on Nintendo systems will you be able to enjoy all the different experiences in this Toys to Life category. Along with Amiibo, both Disney Infinity and Skylanders Trap Team have unique features and functionality that can only be found on Wii U. There's a special chip that's embedded in every figure. Any Wii U system will recognize the figures by touching them on the Wii U gamepad. And when that happens, they spring to life in compatible games in cool new ways. When you touch Amiibo to the gamepad, the character's data is downloaded into the game you're playing. And it's also a two-way street. We can send information back to the figure. So in other words, your figure's data changes as you play, which opens the door for various new gameplay possibilities. For example, your own figure with its own unique stats and fighting style will not only appear, but also evolve as a fighter in Super Smash Bros. On Wii U. In fact, Super Smash Bros. For Wii U will indeed be the first game to support Amiibo. In other words, this holiday, we're not only releasing the game you've been waiting for, but also Amiibo that literally gives you new ways to play. As you saw in my battle with Mr. Iwata, when you use an Amiibo in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U, that character will appear as a fighter in the game and compete in battles, developing its own unique attributes and skills. You can fight against them yourself, have them score off against other Amiibo. They can even join you and fight on the same team. But Super Smash Bros. Is just the start. Amiibo play is also being prepared right now for a number of other Nintendo games. One of those is a game many of you are already playing, Mario Kart 8. We'll have more details on that and other games soon. I'm guessing you've got a lot of questions, but there's much more to cover in this digital event today. So I'm going to ask you to do this. When we're done here, at any time, you can catch Nintendo of America's own Bill Trinan, who's hosting a dedicated Amiibo video that goes into a little more detail.
Let's not watch that.
So be sure to find him at Nintendo.com or the Nintendo YouTube channel.
I want to know more about this. I'm still pretty confused about this.
It looks terrible.
Super Smash Brothers and Amiibo are big initiatives.
So bad.
But now it's time to give you a sneak peek at some of the many projects in development. Whenever I'm over in Japan and lucky enough to see these new games, I'm reminded of the first video game I fell in love with, Super Mario World on my Super NES. I played it endlessly, finished with 99 lives, and I still have that cartridge. I bet you remember the first game you fell in love with, too. Those of us who play games know that there's nothing quite like them in the world. And those of us who love Nintendo know that no matter what's going on in our lives, we can always count on these games to deliver fun and great gameplay.
Not always.
Because it's Nintendo.
What is it like to make these games?
Well, you're about to find out directly from our development teams. They're working on some amazing new projects that underscore the point that there's never been a better time to play games on Nintendo platforms.
Except on the weekend.
At the end of the day, Nintendo game creators share one belief. There's nothing wrong with having a little fun. With that, I'm going to step aside to let our developers show you their new games. Enjoy the rest of the show.
It's Reggie. What's this? It's Tetris.
Yarn.
Kirby's
No, guys,
it's Yoshi.
Burn it with fire.
No, this is actually happening.
I'm Tezuka of Nintendo. How do you do?
We like yarn.
I'm Emisu of the Good Feel Company. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no, this is Yoshi.
When Nintendo reached out to Good Feel, we didn't ask them to make Yoshi's Woolly World as a sequel to Kirby's Epic Yarn. We said we wanted to make a Yoshi game.
Maybe in this game you could actually die and they'll
be, you know, challenged. But we asked them to use the yarn and fabric as materials for creating new gameplay mechanics.
It's an easy game, but there's
just looks like a Yoshi.
To create a new kind of Yoshi game filled with those kinds of elements.
But I would like more if this was just, like, maybe a couple of levels.
I'd like it if it was one
For Kirby, we used strands of yarn as the core element and expressed things through their movement. This time, now that we were working in a three-dimensional world with depth, the challenge was that a single strand wasn't going to be visually impressive. So how do you play with a pile of yarn? Or some cloth.
Don't!
You get unraveled and knitted up, and do a lot of things like that.
Oh, look, you can throw a pipe and then go through it.
Both Mario and Yoshi games are 2D action platformer games.
You'll be fired later.
I'll let it shake my ass.
What is that?
It's Yoshi. The big difference is that Mario games are about performing challenging tasks within a given time.
But with Yoshi games, they don't have any time limits. So you're able to freely explore the vast game.
Or any challenge.
Oh my god!
You can
bad.
Make new discoveries. It's turning out to be an action game where you can have fun in a wide variety of ways.
When you usually make an action game, things like how far you can jump are set at a certain distance, so you would build the terrain with that in mind. But in the case of Yoshi, he's so almighty. If he tries, he can fly as far as he wants.
We had talked about this the other day.
Jesus confirmed.
His tongue is the most powerful weapon. Well, it may be weird calling it a weapon.
Comes out of his ass.
So, as we were thinking about how we should build the game, Tezuka-san told us that it centered around exploration. We took it as Yoshi's abilities are there to be utilized for exploration. From there, we were able to progress with the game's development smoothly.
By using yarn, there are new ways to explore.
There are a lot of transformations in the game because Yoshi himself is made of yarn.
Yeah, it's kind of a creepy. Oh, he does the ninja. I love that.
So this time, we put in two-player mode. Two Yoshis appear, and that actually plays really well. Two people can play to help each other out.
They should already have that. Yeah, that's kind of all better.
So in tough situations, if there are two players, they can both overcome it.
Sorry about that. We're recording, but you know.
Yoshi
Thank
can
you.
Eat up
Thank
and
you.
Spit out the other Yoshi wherever he likes.
Oh my god!
This is
oh my god!
Hannibal
oh.
confirmed for Yoshi! Hannibal confirmed for Yoshi!
This is.
Really, a wide range of gameplay is possible. We've made prototypes of different ways to express the yarn tab with your Yoshi. And we felt that the stuffed yarn Yoshi was particularly attractive.
Oh, I wouldn't guarantee it. Or hey, just continue.
There was
quite
a phase
B-hops.
Of trial and error until we decided to go
right
with the current form.
Shop.
We kept touching
yeah,
the
this time it's about a textured look. And we also wanted to give the world a handmade feel. But we then asked, what makes things look handmade? We tried making things of our own, hoping that it would help in reflecting the handmade feel to the game.
It's kind of scary.
So you made Yoshi out of yarn in order to...
Yes.
There is certainly a key phrase that I have.
How do I
It's amazing Yoshi.
It's amazing Yoshi. How come the clouds are made out of yarn? They're like stitched together.
I always want to put in the element of surprise. And I want to make it a game that brings a smile to my face just by winning.
I mean,
that wasn't
the
He's like...
I'm
happy.
It looks pretty good.
Looks decent, I guess.
Looks straightful. Yoshi's Woolly World. Let's just be honest.
Wow. Seriously.
It
couldn't
have
a better name.
That's an amazing name.
Let's just be honest.
Oh my god, yes! Yes! Yes!
Wait,
yes! 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 Yes!
Blow up the beast
yes,
microphone.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Stop! Can you not?
A toad.
Okay, so now it isn't here.
Yeah, Toad, the most unrecognizable character in Mario.
Okay, let me explain this. So in 3D World,
I can explain it.
There were mini games called Toads, Captain Toad's Adventure, which were probably one of the best parts of the game. They were little costumes. Yes, this is Captain Toad's Adventure in the game, and I love it. This is amazing.
They made an entire game based on a mini game.
Yes, and it's amazing.
It's Nintendo, what did you want?
I wanted this and they gave it, and so Nintendo wins E3!
I really disagree.
I wouldn't call it a winning thing.
I severely disagree. With the passion, I disagree. Meh. The most generic race in Mario now has its own franchise.
It's amazing.
Nothing.
Not amazing.
It's, yeah. It's
the graphics are good, I'll give it that.
Okay,
yeah, it looks
nice.
Oh.
Hey. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, look, I'm really sorry about kidnapping
you
80 plus times. My bad. So is it cool if I have the last donut?
Use your fire to get justice. No.
I deserve that.
Why is Robot Chicken being advertised for Nintendo when Nintendo's primary audience?
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Guys.
Yeah, guys.
Shut up.
If anybody talks, I will slit your throat.
Last year, I said that revisiting the conventions of the Zelda series would be our theme for the new Zelda game for Wii U. However, before I get into that, let me talk about something that I needed to help to realize this ambition. In fact, it's something that we've wanted to do for a long time in the Legend of Zelda series. And so, development began with this as our focus. In the earlier releases of the Legend of Zelda games, players got to explore a wide area, scrolling up, down, left, and right.
Yeah, that's true.
However, after the game transitioned to 3D and the hardware continued to evolve, it became harder to create that feel of being in a vast world. For example, in Wind Waker, we used various techniques to create a wide world where you could freely explore many isolated islands. But it was very hard to create one large world where everything felt connected. We had to design small, bounded areas with a defined entrance and exit. And putting them all together made it feel like you were playing in a large world. But you still couldn't cut through the boundaries wherever you like to explore that world. Today, I'd like to talk to everyone about the latest Zelda game for Wii U. But first, please take a look at how the game looks on screen.
Oh,
wow.
This is the new world of Zelda.
It's like a nice looking sky.
It's quite a vast world, isn't it?
And
you can even reach those mountains in the distance if you walk far enough.
It's Skyrim!
We couldn't create such a wide world like this in the past. As far as what you can do with such a vast field to explore, as soon as those boundaries are removed, it means you can enter any area from any direction. So the puzzle solving in this game begins the moment the player starts to think about where they want to go, how they will get there, and what they will do when they arrive. This is a clean break from the conventions of past games in the Zelda series, where you had to follow a set path and play through the scenario in the right order. I believe this departure will create opportunities for new gameplay that have not been experienced in previous Zelda games. As you can see, and as you know from the Zelda series, the world in these games can be quite peaceful. However, it is a Zelda game after all, so strong enemies will certainly appear. Even in this setting, powerful enemies appearing in such a peaceful world is one of the defining features of the Zelda series.
I think that one convention we can keep, right?
Right?
Oh, here's the trailer.
Pizza! The most important part of the video. And we're gonna pause for a minute.
Fuck. Sorry for the cut, guys. We're good.
Robots?
Wow.
Okay. Except for the robots.
Again.
Yeah, how's the surprise? We already know this.
why.
Do you ever take those gloves off? No! Take my gloves off, do whatever I want. Here we go. Okay, now. Shut up!
Did witches get dragged to hell?
I don't care.
Is it?
It is.
Yeah, it is Bayonetta! You know what Bayonetta is? Oh, look at that.
It's Bayonetta 2.
Whatever your friend did to get on the other side of these, let's just say she's not having a good day. Welcome to hell, love. I'm not one for pets who don't listen to their master.
You're
probably the only person on the planet who says, go to hell, and
you'll
take me there. I'm afraid I don't have time to dance too long. A friend is waiting for me.
I like you to be the most bored.
You can go another round, can't you?
Yeah, it's ruined. It's ruined. It's ruined. Ruined.
What the fuck?
Fuck off, Featherface.
What?
I like that. Oh! You get the first game, too. Wow.
Don't think I quit for
bad. I'm the general producer of Hyrule Warriors, Koinuma of Koei Tecmo.
I'm the development producer of Hyrule Warriors, Hayashi of Koei Tecmo.
I'm Anuma of Nintendo, supervisor.
There are a lot of us in the Hyrule Warriors development team who grew up playing The Legend of Zelda.
They've shown more footage of the first Legend of Zelda than some of their own games.
So getting the chance to work on this series, we were actually a little nervous.
But Anuma-san told us we could do whatever we like a number of times, and it became the action style that it is now.
A big difference between this and the Zelda games is that you're fighting an army, and there are multiple battles occurring on the field at once. If your forces are in trouble, you'll get a warning. So you have the option to go out there and help out your allies.
What I think is great with the Zelda world is how giant bosses appear. And you have to think about how to beat them. I think those things are what makes the essence of Zelda, which I think will be a new discovery for fans of the Dynasty Warriors series.
There's also a two-player mode.
You can play two players by using both TV and gamepad. It's not a split-screen experience, so you're able to each be fully immersed on a single screen.
Well, it sounds cool, but it sounds like...
There are a lot of playable characters. But you know, since it's The Legend of Zelda, there are Link and Princess Zelda.
It looks so good! Impa,
who appears through the series, is playable as well. Also, Midna from Twilight Princess makes an appearance as a playable character.
What?
If there is a certain character you like in the series, this is the first game where you'll be able to play as your favorite character.
Oh my god.
What about
there are a lot
Navi,
of playable
bro,
characters
bro,
in the Dynasty Warrior series.
Imagine Navi.
But man,
oh yeah,
the ideas they come up with for what kind of moves they give the characters are amazing. They really think of amazing things.
Yeah, I'm pretty much sold.
So now, it's really turning out as a great new Zelda collaboration title that's worthy of the name Hyrule Warriors.
Since this collaboration was a first of its kind, we were able to make it a great game that's like a celebration of both franchises. I really hope you all look forward to it.
As a collaborative title, it has both the essence of Zelda and the essence of Dynasty Warriors, as well as a lot of other essences they have all mixed in to form a brand new experience. It'll be great if both fans get interested in playing the other series. It'll make me really happy if they all have fun playing.
Apparently,
yeah, I like the symbol with like the scarf.
Oh, in September.
I don't
know why
everybody hates that blue scarf. I love it, really.
It's, oh my god, Playfighter
remake!
Is it? Oh god, it's so hype. All the hype. Not impressive. Wow. Let's destroy Kirby in as many ways as we can.
Let's see how many art styles can we move next. Next is Kirby and Nintendo.
I voted.
Oh, whatever. I don't know my art. It's another. This is a shoot that I've already worked with. I like
it. I don't know. It looks like I could get destroyed.
I think this is made by the robot.
人工的な運命解放者頭の文字を取ってブレイド。
私はエルマ。
あなた、名前は?
おお、あの方をお迎えする器が今我が元に。
失って、こんな星まで来たのに、数滅するの。それが私たちの運動の。え、それ、ジーナブレイドプラスガンダム。ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、ちょっと待って、 Yeah.
Like,
Yeah, this is really good.
I'm
like,
for
the Bible.
You guys are
sinner.
Okay, so it is. Okay, so you get it. Yeah. Cool.
2015.
What the hell? Oh, it's
hot.
Oh, yeah. No, they don't need that anymore. What?
Thanks for coming back, Mario.
Oh, okay,
maybe now you reconsider announcing Mario Ballet. What about Star Fox?
Oh, God damn it. Wait.
Element. What the hell?
That's it.
Paintball. Ooh, graphics are bad. This is bad graphics are bad. It looks like you're floating, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, that's not okay.
Nickelodeon.
Alright,
we're gonna
end with Ocean 3. Yeah, actually.
Ocean 3.
Hi, I'm Nogami, producer of Splatoon.
I'm Amano, one of the game's directors.
And I'm the other director, Sakaguchi.
Splatoon is an 8-player, 4-on-4, online multiplayer action game. It's all about controlling territory. Teams battle to claim their turf by splattering the map with ink, and the team with the most territory, when time runs out, wins.
Nogami-san actually came up with the squid idea. One day, out of the blue, he was like, hey, let's make them squids.
Rather than designing the characters and then making a game around that, we instead came up with the game first and then created characters we thought would work well with the gameplay. That's actually how Nintendo prefers to approach game design.
One day, when Sakaguchi-san and I were hanging out on our day off, he said, hey, what if you're able to switch between being a squid and a person? For example, say you can only shoot ink as a person, but as a squid, you're able to perform a wider range of actions. With that as our main concept, we thought about different ways to expand the gameplay, and the squid idea meshed perfectly.
We thought of things like, what if you can swim really fast in your own ink as a squid? Or what if your feet get stuck when walking through enemy ink? Through this process, we kept expanding the game's features, which brought us to where we're at now, with players able to do things like ink and swim up walls and swim super fast through their own ink.
As a person, your first priority is shooting ink to expand your territory. Once you've done that, you've got more turf to move through as a squid and make use of your squid abilities.
One thing I would say a problem with is that basically the more territory you have.
When you're using the gamepad, you can quickly look up or tilt your gaze downward to aim. It's really natural and intuitive. I think these controls are a great use of the gamepad's gyro sensor.
An overhead view of the entire map is also displayed on the gamepad. And you can check it to see what colors of ink are being splattered where in real time. This really lets you keep an eye on how the battle is unfolding.
Normally with shooters, you only get moment-to-moment glimpses of the action. But because of the layering nature of splattering the ground with ink, you can tell by glancing at the map what other players are up to and where they're headed. I think that adds a new layer of strategy to a game like this. Spices it up a bit. The other neat use of the gamepad is making use of your allies' icons displayed on the map. If you tap one of these icons, you'll blast off from your location and land next to them ready to go. This is just one more mechanic that adds a nice twist to the strategy.
Your enemies are shooting ink as well. With regular guns, you can't really see bullets flying by. But since this is ink, you'll be able to see it flying from around a corner, and you'll know, whoa, there's a bad guy over there.
If you forge forward and ink a path, your allies will be able to use it to follow you, and you'll be able to get to your enemy's territory quicker. But on the other hand, they can just ink over that and ruin your strategy. In this way, splattering ink is both an offensive and a defensive tool.
There are a lot of different ways to play depending on your style. Some people like to stay hidden in the ink for a long time and wait for the perfect chance to pop out. Other people just blaze ahead inking a path to try to get as far as they can into enemy territory as fast as they can. There are a lot of different tactics you can employ, but no matter how you play, the ink you're shooting has an effect on everyone else. You'll never feel like you're playing alone or in a vacuum. It's pretty magical, really. Amano-san, you like to try and ambush people, right?
Do I? Yeah, I guess so.
I play it a bit safer and lay down a lot of ink and make it hard for enemies to advance into my team's territory. I like to stay at home and protect the base.
Yeah, that's not my style at all.
I'm just playing bad.
Yeah, Nogami-san, you're really not very good.
This is the part.
Just about wraps up things for the Nintendo Digital event. But at the same time, it's just the beginning of your continuous contact with Nintendo at the show this year. First of all, right after we sign off, we invite you to stay tuned on Nintendo's Twitch channel for our post-show recap, Nintendo Minute Live at E3. There's even more game news we didn't have time to squeeze into this video. If you're in the LA area, we invite you to come on down to the Super Smash Bros. Invitational this afternoon. It's a one-of-a-kind tournament in the Nokia Theater at LA Live to see as much Super Smash Bros. Live action as you could ever want. You'll find more details at e3.nintendo.com/invitational. But Nintendo's experience at E3 is also spreading across the country, thanks to our partnership with Best Buy. You'll find more details at bestbuy.com/smashfest. And if you want to just follow along without ever leaving home, our coverage is going to be nonstop. We're going to be broadcasting Nintendo Treehouse live at E3 from the show floor directly on Nintendo's Twitch channel. If you care about games, want to see more of the action, and hear from many of the people who created those games, this is binge heaven. And yes, Mr. Miyamoto will be among the guests. Follow us on our Twitch and YouTube channels. Get more information at Nintendo.com.
Yeah,
follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and join the Miiverse E3 community. We've covered a lot of ground today, so I want to thank you for watching. But I just can't leave you without one more little teaser. Enjoy E3 and play Nintendo.
I don't know.
Yeah,
oh,
I
don't. Okay, that was fast.
This is the one.
This fight from Hyrule is quite impressive.
Yeah.
The process. The process. Kid Icarus
anime.
It does?
Yes.
What?
You're nothing compared to the other gold army.
Why haven't I seen this? Holy
there's
crap!
Like three different, like,
oh my god! Series.
This is like an actual show.
I would watch the hell out of it.
There's three. It's not a show. It's like the background by
Elijah, why didn't you tell me this earlier? What's wrong with you?
There's like three of them.
Oh
like
my god.
Not three shows.
Look how awesome this is.
There's three different episodes. Like, different.
I'm guessing like Link's in a cave.
Exactly. Though I kind of wanted to.
Yeah. Exactly.
Oh my god. This is magical.
Yes.
Shit.
That was so disappointing.
In classic
good
anime
job,
style.
Huh?
This isn't even her final form.
Lady Palutena?
No, that voice though!
Lady Palutena?
Lady Palutena? Wow!
Coming for your
lights.
I'm here for a little, divine intervention.
Dub's bad. Dub is bad.
Wait, you want to fight too, Lady?
Look how nice that is!
I'm no stranger to fighting.
Are
you
your attacks?
I dig it. I really dig it. Look how cool
yeah,
it is.
Sure, but that was when the Chaos Skin had you under mind control.
How come it sounds like a
nerd? I got it. You said it.
Was that
perhaps you'd like to see some of the powers I gave you to protect you.
Was that this point in good?
Heavenly Light.
Reflect! I'll have
a vertical. Jump right! Counter! Super
Well, I'm gonna punch you! Well, you know, she did begin with an anime clip, so what do you expect?
Mega laser!
Oh my god!
Is that a Final Smash?
Somebody snap
a laser!
Anything to me, Lady Palutena.
Look, Palutena!
Many worthy foes have gathered here. And I won't hold back on anyone.
Nice.
Is there anything else?
They could have just announced two characters.
No, they could. Maybe they'll announce something
just
like
just gonna stand there. Come on, one more character.
Dark Pit. You just dropped in to crash my party?
Uh-huh. I'm a douchebag. Angst, angst, angst. Is there anything else?
Oh!
What?
Miyamoto!
Miyamoto,
what are you doing? Go back in your room!
Miyamoto desu. Konnichiwa. あのね、今
Wait,
電波ッドと、
like、
テレビを使った新しいゲームをいっぱい作ってます。これはね、とても新しい体験のゲームがたくさんできたんですけども、今度 E3 でいくつかお見せしたいと思います。ゲームパッドを使って遊んでると大きなテレビを見せて、遊んでる人以外にも周りで見てる人も楽しいんですね。でぜひとも周りで見てても楽しい新しい経験を E3 のフロアでも見ていってください。よろしく。
Nope.
Nope.
That's
it.
That's
it.
That's
it.
Wait,
that's
is there any Nintendo E3 videos we could watch?
How about Noble?
Is that seriously it?
Wow, they only added two characters.
But they were two good characters.
Yeah,
I said three. I was so
I said like five.
Yeah, same. I said five.
Just put your stuff in.
Well, may I put my...
That was that.
That was that.
That hey, Ashley.
It looks good, but I still feel disappointed.
I liked it.
No, I don't feel disappointed.
I feel disappointed because like, there wasn't enough.
There was, okay, they did announce something. Okay, so the Zelda game looks amazing.
The Zelda game looks good.
Like,
both
Zelda
games look good.
Yeah, yeah. And then I like Smash Brothers, obviously.
Looks really good.
So yeah, it was weird. There's no 3DS games.
Yeah.
At all.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
I find like the 3DS right now is a really top selling unit and top selling games, and they didn't announce a single thing for it.
Yeah. Okay. So if you like this video, please make sure to like. If you like this video, please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and all that jazz. Yeah. E3.